Well, there seem to be plenty of videos on how to conduct experiments using Taguchi methods. There seem to be hardly any describing the pitfalls of Taguchi methods. So let me remedy the situation. So what are the criticisms about the Taguchi methods? So first of all, it mixes up signal and noise using a ratio. Secondly, the recommended orthogonal arrays are aliased. And thirdly, the array structure recommended results in more runs. Okay, now let us see each of these in detail. So, first of all, signal to noise ratio mix up. So, signal to noise ratio is for the case where nominal is best is defined by the log of y bar square by s square. And maximizing signal to noise ratio can be achieved by having a large value of y bar or a low value of s or both together. For example, suppose in an experiment, when A is at a low level, we get the readings 3, 4 and 5, resulting in an average of 4, standard deviation of 1 and signal to noise ratio of 1.20. And when A was high, we got readings 2, 4, 6, resulting in an average of 4, standard deviation of 2 and signal to noise ratio 0.6. So, signal to noise ratio is highly different, but the average is same and standard deviation is different. Suppose in another case, for A low we got the readings 2.5, 5 and 7.5, resulting in an average of 4 with standard deviation of 2.5. Signal to noise ratio is 0.6. And when A was high, we got readings 2, 4 and 6, resulting in an average of 4 and standard deviation of 2. Thereby, signal to noise ratio remaining again 0.6. Now, signal to noise ratio is equal, but the average is higher at A low and standard deviation is lower at A high. So, which is better, you can't be sure, depends on the situation. Thus, there is no guarantee that maximizing signal to noise ratio will minimize us or vice versa. So it is assumed that a unit increase in log of y bar square and a unit increase in decrease in log of s square are equally desirable, but this may not always be justifiable. So instead, it would be better if we work with s square as the response variable or its log, rather than mixing up two together in the signal to noise ratio. Secondly, the orthogonal arrays recommended by Taguchi are aliased. For example, in the L8 array, the main effects are confounded with two-factor interactions. And in arrays with three or more levels, they have highly messy alias structures. For example, the L8 array alias structure can be obtained using software like Design Expert or from books, and we can see that A is aliased with BC or DE or FG. Similarly, B is aliased with AC or DF or EG. C is aliased with AB or DG or EF. And D is aliased with AE or BF or CG. Now we suppose we allocate factor A to this column, factor B to the second column, and the third factor is allocated to C, then C and AB will be mixed up. We cannot distinguish whether the effect of C is due to C or interaction AB. So if the three factors are allocated to A, B and D, then it is all right. So there is a chance of making mistakes in these designs. Similarly, in the L9 array alias structure, it is highly complex. So here BC, BD, CD are all aliased. So we can't be sure which effect is the really significant one and causing this overall effect. So that is the problem with this three-level array structure. And thirdly, the inner array, outer array structure recommended for some designs, for some experiments, results in much larger number of experiments. I'm not going to the details. Please refer to the paper by Nair VN, Taguchi's Parameter Design, a panel discussion, published in Technometrics in May 1992, Volume 34, Number 2. Thank you for listening to me.